Hello everyone. Now in this video, we will learn the next concept of interest rate derivatives, which is called as FRA or Forward Rate Agreement. Friends, this is a very interesting and simple concept. What I will do is I will show you these presentations and based on this, we will discuss it together. Friends, you remember the concept of forward contract? A forward contract is a contract entered today for a future date. Just like that, an FRA is a contract entered today for a future date to borrow a certain sum of money at an agreed future rate. So friends, maybe we'll look at this table and we'll try understanding. In this table, there are three dates given. Jan 1, 2020, 31st March 2020, 31st March 2021. On Jan 1, 2020, I actually want to borrow 100 lakhs at 10% after 1 year for 1 year duration. What I mean by that is that I want to borrow 100 lakhs on 31 March 2020. Sorry, not 31 March 2020, friends, it will be 31st December 2020. Okay. This date is going to be 31-12-2020 and this date is going to be 31-12-2021. I hope you are clear with this part, friends. So Jan 1, I borrow money, I enter into an FRA means I want to borrow after 1 year at 10%. After 1 year, the actual rate can either become 6% or the actual rate can become 12%. If the actual rate becomes 6%, still I will have to borrow at 10%. Hence, I will make a loss of 4%. If on that date the actual rate turns out to be 12%, still I will have to borrow at 10% and my gain will turn out to be 2%. This is the logic of the word forward rate agreement. Let's go to the next page now. Friends, what I'll do now is I'll show you the impact of this through using two situations. Situation 1, where the actual rate turns out to be 6%, and situation 2, where the actual rate turns out to be 12%. Situation 1, if you look down, the FRA rate is turning out to be 10%. Alright, just a minute, friends. This will be 31-12. Here also 31-12. FRA rate is 10%. Suppose the actual rate turns out to be 6%. In that case, I am making an actual loss of how much percentage, friends? 4%. This loss of 4% means, listen very carefully now, on 100 lakhs of loan, 4% will turn out to be how much? 4 lakhs. This 4 lakh will accrue on 31-12-2021. It will accrue at this point because the rate changed on this date and this is 6% per annum. So now friends, my loss is 4 lakhs on 31-3-2021. But when do I get information about this loss? I get information about this loss on 31-3-12-2020. I get the information at this point itself. So friends, my question to you is, will I wait for 1 year to pay this money? No, I will pay the money now itself, but will I pay 4 lakh or will I pay less than 4 lakh? I will pay less than 4 lakh, or what I will do is, I will pay the present value of 4 lakh at a discount factor of 6%, which turns out to be 3,77,358. This is what we call it as the settlement amount. Now I'll take you to the next scenario. As I mentioned earlier, in the second scenario, the actual rate turns out to be 12%. Now I am making a gain of 2 lakhs. This 2 lakhs of gain is accruing on 31st March 2021. If it is happening on that date, I am making an actual gain of 2 lakh rupees over there. This 2 lakh I am making on 31-12-2021, but I get the information as on 31/12/2020. So rather than waiting for 1 year, I will settle the money today itself at the present value of 2 lakh at how much percentage? 12%, which turns out to be 1,78,571, which is again called as the net settlement amount. So friends, I hope you're clear with the logic of FRA, because FRA is a contract entered today for a future date so that I can borrow certain sums of money for a future date. I will now go to the next slide. This is what I call it as practical FRA. When you are writing notes, you can put it this way. Subconcept number one was FRA basics. Subconcept number two is practical FRA. Friends, practically, there are two markets. I call the first one as a real market, second one as the imaginary market. You can call them as a spot market and the FRA market. I want to borrow 100 lakhs after 1 year for 1 year duration at 10%. At the end of 1 year, the actual rate turns out to be 6%. Now there are two markets, the FRA market and the spot market. Today, that is Jan 1, 2020, I will actually borrow in the imaginary market. Is that real or imaginary? Imaginary. On expiry, I will cancel that position. Look at this. First, I borrow at 10. Then I cancel this position at how much percentage? 6%. So I make a loss of how much in the FRA market? 4%. Is this 4% real or imaginary? It is real. Whereas in the real market, now I can borrow at how much percentage? 6%. So overall, I end up paying how much money? 10%. Is this not the FRA rate I entered into? Or friends, let's put it this way. Let's say the spot bank is SBI and the FRA bank is some bank which I call it as a derivative bank. Alright, so when I put it this way, what I'm trying to tell you is that FRA is a separate bank, SBI is a separate bank. These two need not be interlinked. They may be one, they may not be one. So friends, the ideal objective for me is that I should be able to sleep peacefully. I should be able to borrow at 10%. I should not think that had I not entered into FRA, I would have made a profit of 6% and I would have saved 4%. You can't think that way. Or you can also think in this way, here it became 6. What if it had become 12? Let's go to the next example, which will make it clear to you. Over here, I borrow at 10% in the FRA market. The actual FRA, the actual rate, this 12% is not the FRA, this 12% is the actual rate turns out to be 12. I make a gain of 2 over here. Here I borrow at 12 because the market rate becomes 12 in the real bank, which I call it as the SBI. So I end up paying how much percentage over here, friends? 10%. Friends, or in other words, whichever way the interest rate moves, I will end up paying only 10% and I can sleep peacefully. This is the logic of FRA. So friends, we learned theoretically what is FRA. We learned practically what is FRA. Now I will share with you a few terminologies of FRA. 3x6 FRA, 3x9 FRA, 6x9 FRA. Friends, 3x6 FRA means I am borrowing after 3 months for 3 months duration, which will get over at the end of the 6th month. 3x9 FRA means I am borrowing after 3 months for 6 months duration, which will get expired at the end of the 9th month. 6x9 means I'm borrowing after 6 months for a duration of 3 months. I hope you're clear with this video, friends. Thank you so much.